This video will show you how to perform a test of hypothesis for a single population mean. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using the LA County Ozone Random dataset from the Rguroo User Guide repository. If you would like assistance loading this dataset, please watch our video specifying data on an inference for population means. Take a moment to pause the video and read the prompt I've presented in front of you. From the Analytics pane, scroll down to Analysis, and then click on Mean Inference. Select the dataset LA County Ozone Random, and for variable 1, we are going to choose September. Rguroo automatically fills in the summary data in the Population 1 box below. This box also gives you the ability to change the label of your population. September Ozone would be the label of my choice. Now to construct the test of hypothesis, scroll over to the Population 1 tab. Rguroo will not conduct an analysis without Population 1 data. However, the menu under Population 2 is exactly the same as Population 1, should you wish to perform two separate tests of hypotheses at the same time. Now within the Population 1 tab, you'll see two subtabs, one for a confidence interval and the other for a test of hypothesis. Let's click that one. By default, Rguroo sets the significance level at 5%, but can be edited should you wish to choose a different alpha level. The alternative hypothesis is a mandatory field that seeks to examine if the data provides sufficient evidence to support the City Council's claim. In this case, we are looking to prove that the ozone levels in September are not equal to 0.052. The drop-down menu consists of three choices, and it's the last one that represents not equal to. Rguroo has the ability to perform test of hypothesis using a t-statistic, a z-statistic, a bootstrap t-statistic, and or a bootstrap sample mean, also known as a bootstrap unscaled method. As you can see, the default method for performing a hypothesis test is the z-statistic. If our sample size was really small, this would not be an appropriate statistic. However, we can choose from any of these methods since our dataset is large enough and we are using raw data, which is required for implementing a bootstrap method. Hit the preview icon, and you're done. Now the term research hypothesis is used for describing the alternative hypothesis, so don't let this worry you. The table states the values of the standard error, the observed z-statistic, the bounds of the critical region, and the p-value. Rguroo even states if the results are significant in the red text below. Each test also comes with two visual representations that show why the null hypothesis is rejected or not rejected in favor of the alternative hypothesis. On the p-value graph, the area under the density to the left of the observed value is colored red. And because we have a two-tailed test, symmetrically an equal area is shaded on the right. The total combined area represents our p-value. On the critical region graph, the areas shaded under the density curve indicates the critical or rejection regions that correspond to a significant level of 5%. As shown in this graph, the observed value falls in the critical region. So at the 5% significant level, we can conclude that there is sufficient evidence that the mean ozone level in September is not equal to 0.052. For more information on implementing a test of hypothesis for a single population mean and the various methods to do so, please reference the chapter, Inference for Population Mean, from our user guidebook.